Good evening, everyone. I'm Esther Bernstein from Saffyre Sanctuary, and welcome to our first edition of Dear Caley. And Dear Caley was inspired by the old article Dear Abby, where people would write in and ask questions to Dear Abby about general things in life and such. And so I thought we would take that format and do this with Caley, who passed away last year, but is still with us in spirit and is here to answer our questions. Anything you have to ask from him or from me about Saffyre Sanctuary, our rescue, our horses, how we do things, why we do things, nutritional information, you can just send me a personal message. I will read them off and answer them every week on this video little show. So I don't really have a question that's been submitted yet, but I did want to go into the topic of some of the things that we do. And the first topic we will discuss is rehoming. So Saffyre Sanctuary was founded in 2008. And when you start a rescue and you don't have a place to put any horses and you still want to help, I had to become creative in how I was going to assist horses that I couldn't take in. So what I formed was called our rehoming program. And I wanted it to benefit both the people that needed to place their horses, the people that were getting the horses, and help the horses that were here in our organization. So to start with, rehoming is a tool for horse owners to utilize so they don't have to send their horses to auction or go through the hardship of screening adopters and not really knowing what they're getting themselves into. So the principle of rehoming is, let's say you have a horse that you can no longer keep due to hardship issues, financial issues, health issues. We always like to emphasize the importance of owner responsibility and giving that horse a forever home in your own home, if at all possible. But if life somehow does not allow you to do that, we will step in as the middleman and help you safely find a home for your horse. So what happens is the owner contacts us and they say, can you help us find a home for our horse? And they give us some information. If we are in a position to do so, they will sign a contract with us. It does not cost them anything. And we get a lot of information about the horse. I personally go out and do a site inspection on the horse so that the information that we are relaying to the public is true and accurate. Once I have all that information, we then advertise the horse as if the horse is with us and available for adoption. So we've already got the information from the owner and we've already seen the horse and we know that the horse's limitations and such and can get a feel for exactly what that horse needs. We then screen adopters just like the horse was with us. So the owner must keep the horse during this time we are looking to find people for to effectively adopt the horse. So adopters will contact us. They go through a rigorous screening process. I will personally interview them. I will ask for references and do a site inspection at their location where they plan on keeping the horse. And then if it's a match, the owner then donates the horse to our organization. The adopter then adopts the horse through our organization. We do collect an adoption fee. And a lot of people ask, why are you collecting an adoption fee for a horse that you don't have? And there's a few reasons for that. Firstly, many people, not all of us, but some people may not totally value things that they don't pay for. So we know that if somebody is willing to pay a very small fee for a nice horse, they're serious. We're not catering to people who are looking for free horses. If they can't afford a few hundred dollars for an adoption fee, that gives us a red flag that maybe they don't have the means to properly care for a horse. So it is strictly for the protection of the horse. It covers our expenses for advertising and, you know, our cost of doing business. And as a 100% volunteer organization, that money goes directly to the care and expenses of the horses at our sanctuary. So it's a win-win for everybody. The owner of the horse gets a write-off for donating the horse to our organization. The adopter gets a nice horse that they know exactly what they're getting. And our sanctuary benefits by getting a small fee to help the horses in our custody. And that is rehoming. It's something I handle strictly by myself, but I am looking to, I'm working on partnering with other organizations, helping them with the vetting process and incorporating more rescues into a rehoming program so that this can go larger and that we can help more horses nationwide. So stay tuned for some of that information. We look forward to sharing that with you. I'm going to keep this short and sweet so I don't bore you. And that's just a tidbit of information about us. If you would like to find out more detail about what we do and how we were founded, please visit the website that I'm going to share below this video, changinghorsesthebook.com. And that is my autobiography about how Saffyre Sanctuary was founded and why we do what we do. So I'll answer a lot of questions that you may have about Saffyre, myself, and the horses that we have. And if you have any other questions, please PM me. I look forward to hearing from you. And Caley is looking forward to sharing his insights and wisdom from the other realm. Have a great night and thank you for joining me. Bye-bye.